Good afternoon and welcome to Lunchtime Business. My name is Kevin Britz and my business is Business by Design, where we help people advance their personal peak performance. And today we have on our Lunchtime Business, Pieter Gruenbaum, a business and transformational coach who helps people transform their businesses. Hey, Pieter, how are you doing?
Hi, good afternoon, Kevin. Very well, thank you. Cold and chilly, but I suppose that's what we need. Otherwise, very well, thank you. Thanks again for this opportunity to speak to business owners out there and people in general.
Fantastic. Pieter, so last time we chatted, we spoke about time management and also, you know, taking consideration on how we spend our time and how to proactively get involved with being more consciously aware about our time. Don't you want to wrap up from where we left off and then move into, I know you've got something to share for us, and then yeah. Move into that and tell us what we're chatting about today.
Yeah, surely. What we remember over the past few weeks, we've been talking about the first block or step in getting to the six steps of mastering your business or to great results in your business. And the first step was mastery, where we handled money mastery and destination mastery and time mastery and also delivery mastery and each of these factors that you need to implement in your business. So I'm actually just inviting the guests and the listeners and the viewers to actually go and watch those videos again that to get up to speed if this is the first time you watch. Now, today we're moving on to the next step in the six steps. The next step is what we call niche, and it's all about creating a predictable cash flow and not eliminating the chaos like in mastery.
Absolutely. Yeah, so and so many people, I know that some advice out there is that, you know, you shouldn't create a niche. But from what I have experienced in business, and I'm sure yourself as well, having that niche really speaks to your audience and understanding who you are and why you're tackling or targeting them as an audience. So please go ahead and share your screen with us and let's tackle that niche, because I'm quite curious to see how you put that together and what those steps would be.
Okay, cool. I will do that. Let me just open it there for you.
Okay.
Fantastic.
All right. Can you see that? Hopefully it's nice and clear for you guys.
Yeah.
All right. So what is a niche then in actual fact? We say this next step niche is predicting your cash flow. So you do your marketing correct. So you have the cash flow that you need to carry on. Okay. Yeah. So our definition of a business is it's a commercial profitable enterprise that works without you. Okay, so and let's look at the definition of a niche for us. As action coach, we say it's no price competition. Okay, so the niche, if you look at the definition of a niche, it's a specific niche that you create or space that you create that you actually work in and look at in your business. So it's target marketing specific and that type of thing. So to create that no price competition, but there's a few steps that you need to do to go through, and that's what we will cover today. Because no price competition, everybody tells you, but it's price. Price is everything. Well, looking at it from a different angle, price isn't everything. Okay, and that's one of the main reasons or a reason that people use as an excuse to not buy from you. But it's only an excuse. Okay, there are different factors which we'll talk at a later stage.
Yeah.
About. All right. So create your niche. How do you create the niche? It's a unique selling proposition. Okay, a USP for short. A unique specific thing that you sell or that you do or that you deliver as a service that creates that niche for you. In your target market. Okay, and creating your niche, also creating a guarantee. Right, so let's look at each of them a little bit individually as a unique selling proposition we start with. Most of us, well, I would say 99.9% of businesses do something unique already. It's just going out and looking at what is that specific thing that we do uniquely, okay? And out of that, create your target market, create your vision of your direction for where you're going to market in, and do your marketing in. It must be, as we say, it must be truly unique. It must be something different from anybody else. Okay, it's not just great service, because great service is a given. Everybody expects great service. So it must be something truly unique in your business. And things that you, if you go through and think about your business as it is, there's a lot of things that you do, maybe three or four or five things, if you think of it, that you do uniquely. Okay.
I want to add to that, because I think it's quite a generic thing that people go, you need a USP, and I've heard it. But essentially, you know, if I look at the Lunchtime series that my business has created, part of what I'm currently targeting is quite unique, because absolutely, the way that I put that together and how it's approaching an audience and how it's, you know, stepping into a marketing sphere, it's really started creating a unique entry into the market of what I do and how I do what I do. Part of my slogan, and I put it on my Instagram page, but part of the slogan is your strength is your uniqueness. Absolutely. And a lot of people don't realize that unless you sit down and really kind of define, it doesn't matter what it is, you know, it really depends on how you as an individual business owner go out there and present yourself uniquely. Because
absolutely.
Hundreds of coaches, for example, you and I are both coaches, but how you do what you do and how I do what I do is quite specifically and tailored to both of us and how we do what we do uniquely. So USP is unbelievably important, and I think a lot more people should pay attention to why they sort of need to understand what that means to them, and how to actively get their brains wrapped around what is unique about what you're doing as an individual or a business out there.
Precisely. All right. I agree with you full-heartedly. There's a lot of stuff that we genetically do the same, if I could put it that way, but I'm an individual that's unique. You are a unique individual, and you think differently to what I think. You've got different perceptions with the world than I have. And the same with businesses out there. Every business owner is unique in their own sense, and their businesses are unique because they are the drivers of their business. So I can't agree with you more. Okay, but it's not just putting it out there and hope for the best. You must also test and measure it. Testing headlines, and we like you have got a headline that you use in your business, and so have I, but you need to test it and see whether it actually gets any results or any comments, and change it a little bit and pivot and to test it again, so that you can find the real uniqueness that resonates with your clients or your prospective customers.
Yeah, I mean, one of the slogans, now that you mention that, one of the slogans that really people really start paying attention to is no one performs over and beyond their own self-image. And that's one of the slogans I use on my website. Mm. And when it almost kind of gets people to go, what is that? You know, like they really pay attention. And the reason I use it is because I want to pique people's interest. I want them to kind of go, oh, okay, that's really interesting. I've never really thought of that before. And what do you mean by that when you say that? So, and that's exactly why it's there. You know, it's there because I want you to have some kind of intrigue. And, you know, from my coaching methodology, I don't want you just to think of me as one of those guys that does coaching and one of those guys that does leadership programs. It's really an aim of piquing people's interest and really, you know, touching a nerve almost.
Absolutely. So can you now see with your own explanation that we are talking about no price competition, because people are going to go after you as the unique person price doesn't come into play only very late in the negotiation or in the selling process. Does price actually come to bear? But it's not the beginning and the end of it. So price is not part of the equation for a very long time, and that's what we want to try and create by this niche.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. So let's look. Most of us as business owners have seen this, the bell curve of the innovators and the early adopters and the early majority and late majority and laggards, commodity sellers and innovation. Commodity. Where are you in your business? We need to, if you're on the right-hand side of the bell curve, on the late majority or the downward curve to the laggard side, if your products are there, that's what you need to then recreate. So that it can come back to the early adopters, the early majority, and you want to be in the middle with the late, early majority and late majority. That's where the most clients and people buy. Okay, just as an interesting to see what we mean by creating a niche is to create that you go back to the left hand side of the curve, so you can grow again in your products and your services.
Yeah, you know, Peter, I'm so glad that you're sharing this because recently one of my coaching clients, actually, we were just talking about that, and she has a foundational of what she does. And I said to her, well, use the foundation, but innovate in a way so that it starts speaking to a niche and a niche market. But use that same, I mean, she sells the same service, but you can package it in a way that speaks to that audience and speaks to that audience. And that way, she's also now reinvigorating and innovating her own product.
You see?
The foundation of it is still, the foundation of what she teaches. So it makes such sense when you really just wrap your brain around and go, okay, cool, how can I innovate the same thing that I'm doing and what I've been doing for a while? I think that's also part and parcel of business growth. You know, it's important to be able to innovate and create more useful products and services and see what people are really wanting to use and take out from your service.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay. So, yeah, what does not really, I haven't got it on this slide specifically, is that between the 13.5 early adopters side and early majority, there's what they call the chasm, that 3% of where do you go from early adopters to early majority so that your product really takes off or your service really takes off. And that's part of the whole niche scenario as well, to get you to cross that chasm.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So with that goes a guarantee. Now, people in many industries, in basically all industries, can guarantee something that they do. That's actually by law that you have to do. And we don't think of it, but there are certain things that we have to abide by, rules, regulations, as companies, as individuals, for instance, that you have to do. And why don't you guarantee that you will do that to the best of your ability? And it's basically those things that's the key frustrations for clients, for customers. Okay. Just an example for a plumber. I'm not hammering plumbers, but a lot of plumbers, they don't leave your premises tidy and neat and the way they got it, or even better. Many of them aren't really on time. Okay. What one customer of Bradshaw, who is our CEO and founder of those days, he actually went and guaranteed that he will be on time within 15 minutes of the time that was scheduled, and he will leave the premises better and even cleaner than what he received. That made a huge difference in his business.
Yeah.
Okay. So simple things that we do already, that we just put in a guarantee that people can see, okay, but these guys are serious. Okay. As Action Coach, we've got a 17-week, 7-point guarantee, for instance. Okay. We guarantee the results of our coaching that within 17 weeks, we will find our fee in the coaching. And if we don't, we will coach you for free till we do. Yeah. Just an example. Okay. What can be done? All right. So going on from niche, what is marketing? It's buying lifetime customers. And niche is actually getting those customers that you can get your cash flow going. So what do you mean by lifetime customers? Marketing is an investment and not an expense. Okay. Because for every rand you put out in marketing, more rand should come in. Okay. That's not true for every business or most businesses because they see it as an expense because the campaigns don't last. It's not being tested and measured and so on.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's look at two sides of marketing. There's an acquisition cost. Okay. Let's say you invest 3,000 rand in an advertising campaign and you get 10 customers, you pay 300 rand each. So to create that marketing niche is, how can you reduce your acquisition cost? Okay. To create the lifetime value. Because if a customer spends 300 rand for the next 6 years, that's 1,800 rand to you. And you've only spent 300 rand in the beginning to actually just get the customer. How can you increase that? So it's your acquisition cost reduce and your lifetime value increase. How can you increase that spending? Okay. That's through testing and measuring. Okay, and how do we test and measure? We've previously spoke about the five ways. We'd like to just add it in again here because it's such an important vehicle and tool that businesses can use. Okay, the five ways are the numbers of your leads, which is marketing. The conversion rate is selling. Yeah, by all means. Okay, to get your customers. The number of transactions is marketing. The average sale is marketing. Okay, to create your turnover. Your profit margin, that's marketing again. Okay, to get your profit. So let's look at that again and just bring in numbers. Okay, so you've got 4,000 leads, 25% convert yourself, 25% of them, you've got 1,000 customers. Two transactions at 1,000 and each gives you a turnover to 2 million. Okay, times a profit margin of 25%, that gives you 500,000 rand profit. Right, so let's increase each of these just by 10%. So the number of leads to 4,400, conversion rate to 27.5%, it gives you 1,210 customers. That's already 210 customers more. Okay, number of transactions like 2.2 by 1,100 rand per sale, gives you 2,928,200 turnover. That's a 46% increase in turnover. Okay.
Yeah.
You increase your profit margin, gives you 805,255. That's a 61% increase in profit. Okay. So this is how figures, it all looks great. Okay. There are, for each of these steps, there are many strategies that you can follow. Okay. And that makes your target, well, I can put it this way, this is a great tool and starting point for a marketing plan. If you are short on leads, what's your strategies on leads? That's your marketing plan. If you are not converting, you've got a lot of leads, but you're not converting, that's a marketing strategies, that's your marketing plan. So this is a great tool for everybody to use, okay, as a marketing tool to create a marketing plan. And it's specific to what they need in your business. Because as we said previously, this is the business chassis.
Yeah.
Okay. So I want to ask people out there, that they must comment on and send us five things that they can implement right now in their business. Challenge them to contact me or you so that we can do a five ways for them in their business. I'll do it at no cost. Send me your detail, send me whatever you want, and let's do a five ways analysis for your business and see what it looks like. I will do it at no cost. That's an invitation to business out there.
Fantastic.
Yeah. Okay. You've been awfully quiet and I've been ranting. Hopefully I wasn't ranting. Hopefully this is great information that gets put through. Okay.
No, I love that we can share some value like this, Pieter. You know, when it comes to the numbers, I look at the numbers and I think I always apply it to myself and see, well, how am I doing? What am I doing? And steadily taking action on that. Every time we speak, it makes me think. So, yeah, I absolutely love that. Tell us, so for next week, so the action that people need to take is to comment on the social media, on anything that they're taking action on. And you'll sit with them and go through a five point, what do you call it?
The five ways analysis of their business to look at the leads generation and so on. I will do an analysis with them.
Fantastic. Pieter, I'm just going to leave us with the wrap up of today. We looked at our niche. We looked at no price competition and how important that is. We also looked at the USP and working out what your guarantee is. And guys, check that out and re-look at the video so you really get your brain wrapped around it. You can contact either Pieter or myself and we'll be able to give you some advice on that. But the featuring program that Business by Design has this week is your Leadership for Women program. It's a leadership program that's specifically designed for women to know yourself, untapped potential, woman of distinction, your self-image, tracking performance, time versus mind management, rewards of a leader, and so much more. Please go and check it out on businessbydesign.co.za. And the inspirational quote for today, Pieter, is from Will Smith, believe it or not. He says, Don't chase people, be yourself, do your own thing, and work hard. The right people, the ones who really belong in your life, will come to you and stay. I'm going to leave you with that. Thank you so much, guys. Thanks for joining us. Pieter, have a wonderful day, and thanks for sharing. And we will see you next week.
Thank you once again. Given all the best. Safe, guys. Please call me or contact me and Kevin. We really like to interact with you. Just even if it's just a comment from your side or your insights, we love to learn. Thank you.
Absolutely. Thanks, Pieter. Chat to you soon. Cheers. Bye.